Eric called me about 6:45. We just left, and he said they hadn't even left home yet and asked me if I would leave. So you bear with me, and we want to welcome everyone to God's house this evening. Thank you for watching over us to another week, and blessings have us, being so good to us. And Chris, Brother Jerry, and our piano player, normal piano player, is not here tonight, so our pastor, he's going to be playing the piano for us. We got several out of sick tonight, too, so bear with us. But Chris, page 56, Jerry said he'd have a hard time playing, so can we do Victory in Jesus? That'd be all right. Brother Chris is going to preach for us here tonight, so
if
you'll stand and take a hymn book and turn to page 202, all in the glory. Bless this evening's offering, brother.
Precious God, as we bow, we thank you for this another day, Lord. We ask you to be with the remainder of the service. Brother Chris, Lord, we ask you, Lord, to bless the offering, bless everybody that's come out tonight. Father, we ask you to bless this little church. We love you. Yes. We bless you in Jesus' name.
Yeah. Amen.
Patron 20, Victory in Jesus. Thank you. More trouble than anything else. Me and Joe was talking there before church started. One of the biggest problems I've got, we're supposed to cast all our care upon him. And I'll ask him to help me with something if I got a problem. And then the next day I'll try to pick that problem up and help him with it. He don't need me to help him. So that's my human nature, one of my faults, I guess. But we have much to pray about tonight. A lot of people's lost loved ones to death. A lot of people's in hospital rooms, nursing homes. It's good to see Rachel back with us tonight. We're thankful she's feeling better.
Yes.
She's been sick for a
yes.
few. A lot of stuff going on. Marcel has been real sick. So we're thankful that you're able to be back. Bobby and Myra and all. And I wonder who has a spoken request upon your heart before we come to the altar tonight and pray. Yes, Claire.
Linda Wilson called me before, well, a little bit before church time. And they took her husband from the hospital. I know he had a heart attack, but they said August 10th to come back okay.
Good, I'm glad. That sounds good. And Lisa, Marty's wife, they had to rush her to the hospital. I think it was yesterday, but I think she's all right. I called Marty this morning, was real busy at work, and I just left him a voicemail, and he texted me back, and I don't even know how to text people. I've got no flip-lid phones, all I've got, and I can read your text, but I can't text you back. I don't know what to do. I can barely call on that thing. Donna keeps telling me I'm going to have to upgrade, and I don't want to upgrade. I barely know how to use what I got. We're thankful she's okay. And if anybody here knows C.J. Duvall, he's an old-time preacher, yep. 90-something-year-old. He passed away, I think it was maybe Monday or yesterday. Let's remember his family. And Dennis Ponder's wife had passed away. Let's remember Dennis and all that family. You know, the ones that outstripped us and goes on, friends, that's ready to meet the Lord, man, they're in the best shape they've ever been.
Amen.
I had a man come to work yesterday. Said, how's your mama doing? And I said, well, Gary, I said, she died over 3 years ago. He said, man, I forgot about that. I said, let me rephrase that. I said, she's doing the best she's ever done in her life.
Yeah.
Son. She's
got
Amen.
So, Juan, did you have your hand up back there?
Yeah, Kay Taylor.
Yeah,
Kay's been sick. My sister asked for prayer. She had a biopsy today, and she's kind of worried about that, and I asked for prayer that it comes back okay.
Let's remember that. Yes, yes, I.
I got, my mom called me a few days ago after getting her results, and she's got a herniated disc, so they're looking at surgery. And I'm scared to death because my dad had to get the same surgery. So she wanted me to ask y'all to pray for her and just keep me in the prayers.
Yes, we sure will. Let's remember that tonight. God knows who he is, Marcia.
I want to thank everybody for their prayers during my sickness. Continue to remember me and my family. And also my brother-in-law, who's been in the hospital, he got to go home this evening at 4 o'clock. He's got something real rare. It's a osteostenosis. It's a real rare thing that he's got now antibiotic infusion for 4 months, and he's going to do it at home. His wife works in a nursing home, so she knows how to do that, and so she'll be taking care of him. But he's been really, really sick. His sugar is all over the place, blood pressure all over the place, and he needs a prayer.
Let's remember that tonight. Yes, sir. You know, there's no telling what happened to us. I could be up with cancer right now and not even know it. I'm hoping that I'm not, but we don't never know.
Nope.
But there's one thing about it. There's nothing that we can face that God don't know about.
Right.
He knows every fiber of our being, I'm thankful. He's that way. Anybody else has seen? Yes, Chris.
A girl I work with has a cousin that's 21 years old in a wreck Monday night, and she asked to pray for her. They prayed. She's brain dead. They're doing another scan tomorrow. She asked us to pray for the girl as well as the parents that may have to make that decision on what to do.
Pray for Isla. She's had a cold past few days. I'm going to go to the doctor Monday. They said it should be getting better, so we're going to take her Friday for a well visit, and then hopefully she's even better by then.
Yes, sir.
I just know the name. Reason was late. We come down the road right there below the house, and there's a wreck. Guy lived right up the road. It's just been last year. Somebody set him on fire, left him for dead. Anyway, they was drinking, wrecked that little house. I've seen the man. I don't know who he is. I know his name. This is Ken, actually, Pam. But both of them, they need a prayer. The Lord was standing there with walls all over him. Somebody set him on fire and left him for dead, and he's out doing this. Pray God just get a hold of that man. Open his eyes.
Amen. That's right. The meanest person in the world needs one good dose of salvation.
Yep.
Amen.
They were talking to me at work the other day about religion. I said, well, religion will doom you and damn you to hell. And I said, salvation will take you home and be with the Lord. So that salvation is what our country needs. We need to remember our country. It'll wake up and come to God. Anybody else that's seen the spoken knowledge come to your heart? If not at this time, let's gather in the altar. Anyone with objects with a raise of hands, and I have several more also. Let's gather in this altar.
Clarence and Joyce.
Clarence and Joyce Roberts, yes. A good old time preacher of the Lord. Him and his wife both in bad shape. Let's remember them. Is she still in the nursing home, brother?
Yeah.
All right, let's remember that. And, I'm going to ask Eric tonight, if you will, if he'll lead us up to pray. And let's be much in prayer for this service tonight, please. Heavenly Father, it's an honor and privilege to bow in your holy presence this evening. Thank you for your presence this day.
Thank you
for your love and mercy, your kindness bestowed upon us, God. We came to thank you for the breath of air, one good drink of water, the food that we clothes on our
bodies, new every day.
God, the mission blessing you bestowed us,
God's grace,
God's mercy,
and stay with us every day. The psalmist said, surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our
life. On every home, every heart, and every
life. He said, I'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
My wife back at home and help
God, we are blessed people. Blessed because you loved us. God, blessed because you saved us. God, I thank you for saving faith. God, that enabled me to trust the finished work of Christ on the cross. God, I praise you for putting me in the family of God. God, we're blessed. We're blessed with this place. And we're blessed with this fellowship of the saints, God, that we can gather and sing praises unto God. Lift our voices in song and praise unto a holy God. We're blessed. We're blessed, God, that we can still worship God in spirit and in truth. And we're blessed that we welcome the Holy Ghost of God to lead us and to guide us. We're blessed. We're a blessed people. And God, for all your blessings, we thank you. God, for everyone that's here tonight, God, we thank you. And for every day, God, those that were spoken tonight, God, we lift them to you and ask you to work your work of grace. God, that one that needs your touch of God, touch them, heal them, I pray. God, those that are lost, those on the prayer list, God, save them, I pray. God, those that can hear the church bell ring, God, convict them, I pray. Save them, I pray. Oh, God, help us, God, to stay near the cross. Stay humble. Stay in the Word of God. Watch and pray, God, until we hear the trump sound and we go home to be with the Lord. God, we're blessed because there's a land of unclouded sky. There's a land that's fair today. And by faith, we can see it afar. God, the little saints are gathering there. God, that's where our heart is. And that's where home is. God, that's where we long to be. And one day at last, we'll all hit the shores of sweet deliverance and shout while ages roll. Ages roll. We can praise God then in perfect peace and praise. Oh, God, may those that come behind us find us faithful. Faithful to your word. Faithful to the cross. Faithful to you. Keep us in your will. We'll praise you. We'll thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Before we leave, Clarence wanted us to anoint cloth. And when Brother Chris finishes, we'll anoint cloth and take it to Jones. Pray for the first of every year, I try to let the preachers preach on Wednesday night. And we got Chris. We love him. He just become a part of us. And you pray for him as he preaches. And the visitors that are here, it's good to have you. And come back. Come back some Sunday morning. Come back some Sunday night.
Brother Jamie, come sing for me.
Bless you, Lord.
And it's in B flat.
B flat.
Yeah.
What is it?
Yeah.
Well,
you
better.
Pray if he sings.
Bless you, Lord.
And
This right here, folks. Yep. Verses again.
Thou servant, my husband has died. He's dead.
knoweth thy servant did fear the Lord, and the creditors have come to take my two sons to be bondsmen. And Elijah said unto her this question, what shall I do for thee? Tell me what tell me what have thou in thy house? And she replied, thine handmaid nothing, not a thing in the house, but save a pot of oil. Then he said, go ye borrow the vessel abundance of all thine neighbors, even empty vessels, not a few. And when thou art come in, thou shalt come in, thou shalt shut thy door upon thee and thine son, upon thee, thine sons.
Bless the Lord.
And shall pour out into those vessels and thou shalt set aside which is full. So she does, she went from him and shut the door upon her and her sons, and who her sons who brought the vessels to her, and she poured out. And it came to pass when the vessels were full that she said to her son, bring me yet another vessel. And he said unto her, bring me yet another vessel. And he said unto her, there is not a vessel more in old state. Then she came to the man of God, and he said, go sell the oil. And he said, go sell the oil and pay thy debt and live thou and thy children off of the rest. Brother please pray.
Father, we thank you for your word. It's a light unto our path. It's a lamp unto our feet. It's food to our soul and our heart. God, I pray, oh God, that you'd rend the heavens, walk on the mountains, and breathe upon your servant the power of the Holy Ghost. God, give him a liberty, God. May the power of the Holy Ghost lead him and guide him. Touch hearts, bless hearts, save the lost, and we'll praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Well,
what
I
was
saying earlier,
I've got it, buddy.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know. Sorry about that, guys. Well, first of all, first of all, I want to say again, it's an honor and privilege to stand behind this pulpit again.
Listen.
The first time I preached here was a couple of years ago on November 23rd. That's when I preached on James chapter 4, 7 through 10. You remember that when I preached that about an hour and a half message, that when I first preached the first time here. And I said this. It felt good to be behind Pastor Eugene's sacred desk. And it does again. And now I can say Pastor Jerry's too. But like I was saying, we have my first point is, the woman was, they said in the scriptures, the Bible says that she told Elijah that her husband feared God, was a man of God, which is true. But my first point is, God put something in your vessel to make the devil flee. God put something in your vessel. He's talking about the woman would shut the door on her sons and her. And she started pouring out. What the oil is part of the Holy Ghost. And I was thinking when I was studying this message, when I was writing it out and I was reading scripture, I was thinking, what is the things that God put in your house / your tent in your heart that God makes the devil flee? Number one, I didn't write this down, but number one, He put your talent in your house. Number two, He put your worship in your house. Number three, He put your joy in your house. And number four, He put this in your heart. For God loves, because He put this right here in your heart so we can remember it to make the devil bounce. In other words, He's telling us, He's put all that in our heart so we can tell the devil two words. Go away. Get out of my way, baby.
Bless you, God.
We were saying, I was thinking, why does the devil mess with us all the time? He actually, when I was studying this, he told me, you ain't worth it. You ain't nothing. I'm going to tell the devil right here, get thee behind me, Satan.
Bless you, Lord.
Because you're not in my way. Because you can't touch me. Because the only way you can touch me is because God lets you touch me. And His children. Well, he said, what, like I said in the first point, the Bible asked, what Elijah said verse 2 right here. What do you ask her that, this question? What should I do for you? What should, that's what God's asking us. What should, what would you like me to do for you? Number one, and this is my heart's desire, I would love to see souls saved this year in my ministry.
Exactly right, yeah.
What does I want God to do for my ministry? Bring the lost to be saved, number one. Number two, bring a backslider home. Number three, here's for me to grow more in His Word than I ever have.
Right, yes, sir.
And my sixth, the first point I said was, God put something in your vessel to make the devil flee. In James 4:8, you know, it's the second part of that 7, is resist the devil and he will flee. Mm-hmm. How do you resist? You get in His Word, you get in your secret place. I need a little bit of water. Like I was saying, we get, my first point is God put something in your house because to make the devil flee. Number two, I'm in a little hurry because of the time, but number two, get out the Bible. He talks about she told her son, Elijah told her son to borrow vessels, empty vessels, not a few. My second point right here is we need to get out of our comfort zone. Our comfort zone is like when we need to go out in the highways and hedges and compel them to give in.
You're right. Yes, sir. It's true.
If we don't, who will? Mm-hmm. Right. If we don't compel, go out there and fight. That woman tells her them to go knock and get some vessels, not a few, from the neighbor. I believe it's saying out there that we need to go and get them, compel them to come in.
Listen, Lord.
If we as Christians, and I'm telling this myself, I'm guilty too. But if we don't go and get them, the world will. If we don't go out there and compel them, tell them Jesus loves them, and tell them, come here. The Bible says in Luke, I think it's 2, that the angel says, come see a babe. And that means they come to see God. Mm-hmm. But in the Bible, and in another spot, I can't remember, they say, I think of Mary and Martha, they said, I think Mary told Peter and John, come see a man that has risen from the three days from the grave. We need as Christians to get out of our comfort zone. Number three, get along with God, aka our secret place.
Right.
Verse number five. So she went from him and shut the door upon her and her sons, who brought the vessels to her, and she poured out So my last point, the reason why we come, like I was saying, we coming back there in that door, struggling with the world beating us down, the devil beating us down, come through them doors struggling. Don't know what you're struggling with, but God does. But we come in empty, but we leave full. We leave recharged. We come in dead. Our battery's dead. But when we walk back out there, we're recharged. So friend, my last point is, Jesus paid the debt.
Right.
Jesus paid our debt.
Right.
If you look in verse 7, she came back to the man of God and said, go sell that oil that you've gotten in message. Well, Jesus, I'm back here. But Jesus, when he saved us, he paid our debt.
Right.
2,000 years ago on that tree.
Right, brother.
This is for my YouTube. If you don't know him today, God loves. In Romans 5:8, but God commended his love toward us while we yet sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 3:23, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord. Romans 10:13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death, but here's the ticket, folks, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Tonight, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave. God gave. Jesus laid down his life. For Chris Owens.
Yeah.
For Jamie Wong. For Steve.
Right.
For Eric. For all the. For Pastor. He laid his life down freely. On that cross in 3 days, my friend. People say, how is he still pastor? How do we know that he's alive? You'll know. If you don't know, you better check him. Because, friend, if you don't know him tonight, he loves you and he'll stay before it's everlasting. Our kind and gracious Heavenly Father, I want to thank you for one time. Humbly, I know how. Lord, I want to thank you for saving me. Lord, I don't know who's going to be watching this message online, but you do. If there's one lost that watches this service, save them, convict them, save them. Before it's everlasting too late. Lord, I know you're coming back. I don't know when, but you do. But so, Lord, I convey this message unto you. If I've not said or done anything not pleasing to you, Lord, forgive me. Lord,
listen.
Save the lost. Bring the backslider home. Lord, I love you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.